Hi, everybody. Ken Kirschbaumer here with SVG, and I'm joined by Peter Wharton, who's the Director of Corporate Strategy for TAG Video Systems. Peter, how are you doing?
Great, Ken. Thanks for having me here today. It's great to be here.
Sure, glad to have you. So just want to have you for a few minutes here. A few questions for you, so let's fire away. You know, obviously, you're doing a lot of webinars. You did one with me a couple weeks back, so appreciate that. And there was a quote you recently said, which is, the transition to the cloud is not a technology decision, it's a business decision. Can you kind of discuss that a little bit as far as, because I think a lot of people do see it as a technology decision, and then they kind of realize, oh, wait a second, this does have some business repercussions. So,
well, in fact, and if you look at it as a technology decision, you're going to head down some really wrong roads and make some bad decisions because you're forgetting that underneath this really is a business decision. So if you look at our past technology transitions in our industry, they really were driven by technology. The move to digital broadcasting and SDI was a technology shift. The move to HD was a technology shift. And some of these were also customer experience driven, but they're really about technology. The move to UHD and definitely moved to ST2110, right? Nobody moved to 2110 for a business decision as much as because nobody was going to make a mother of all 2000 by 2012 gig router. So if you were building a sports truck, you had no choice but to go to IP. Right. So it was a given. But cloud is different. Cloud is really driven first by we are in an era of uncertainty. We're living in constantly changing business models, right? There's this acceleration to OTT, and we're seeing also the move to closed garden content owner OTT platforms and away from content aggregation OTT, the way Netflix and Amazon Prime started out, and also from MVPD platforms. We're even seeing that the business models underneath are shifting, like Fox, you know, sold their sports to Sinclair, which is now Bally. Does that mean now that gaming is going to be a bigger focus and gambling than actual sports? I don't know. I'm not an expert on any of that. But it does require that you have to build different systems to adapt to these business models. And of course, acquisitions and divestitures. You know, I can't tell you how much money I made over companies who just kept moving around from buying and selling and buying and selling. I had to rebuild the same systems over and over again, right? You know, simply because they were doing that. You know, so as a result, we need technology stacks that can rapidly adapt to these changing business models. No more purpose-built facilities. You know, we can't have these 18-month turn-up times anymore. You know, and I'm seeing companies still building and planning things that have a three-year lead plan on their project. It's like 3 years. Who knows what we're going to be doing in 3 years from now?
Right.
You know, and solution lock-ins. So underneath all this, we're moving from CapEx to OpEx because we're in an era of uncertainty where we don't want to put precious CapEx invested into a technology and a workflow that may be obsolete before we even finish turning it up. And that I think is what really drives the cloud more than anything else.
So obviously you're kind of hinting at it, I think here, you know, does your business model, you know, how does your business model make it easier for people to kind of move to the cloud and move to software based tools as opposed to buying a big piece of hardware that they got to write down over the next 5 to 6 years?
Well, first off, it goes without saying, but we'll say it anyway, that if you're moving to the cloud, you're moving to software and away from hardware. Right. Someone else's hardware, but it's very generic hardware. So you're moving to a software model. A software model gives you that adaptability out of the gate. So that's the starting point, right? And our software happens to be something that works across your entire workflow from live production all the way to OTT delivery and can scale through your entire enterprise. So that's really key because now one tool can adapt to very different needs at different times, not have to go out and buy different tools and for different purposes when the business model changes. But on top of that, we built this rich set of CapEx and OpEx business models that are really designed to address what the customer needs. So a customer moving to the cloud, the first thing you do is build this really complex, convoluted worksheet that models your cost in the cloud. And having done this, this is the most painful exercise you can go through, right? And it's really made 10 times harder if the model for the infrastructure in the cloud, the pricing model for that, and the way you buy it is different than the model for which the services you're running on it are sold. Right? When they don't align, when I have a you know, a CapEx purchase model for software for this, but I'm paying by the hour for that, how do you build a model that factors all that and really understands it? So first, we build models that perfectly mirror what the cloud model is, infrastructure underneath it. That was key because that really simplifies these models and makes it much easier for customers to also understand their costs and assign them to where the cost centers are they need to be. But on top of that, the media companies actually need models that go beyond what the cloud offers. The cloud is built for everybody. And we're not bankers, we're not financiers, we're not car manufacturers, we're media companies, and we need different workflows. So we actually went on top of that and built a bunch of additional models that you could expand on to really optimize what media requires.
Excellent. So as far as, so obviously the sports industry, you know, you're looking at things. I've already talked to people. You know, obviously, the PGA Tour at the Players Championship, they use the cloud to kind of really kind of transform and build out every shot live, which is an amazing service. They use it to distribute content around the world so the rights holders could get the golfers that they wanted. You know, not to have to take the whole feed of golfers that they weren't interested in. So, how do you see sports broadcasters kind of tapping into these capabilities, and then also this business model that you mentioned, and obviously spinning up and spinning down a production as opposed to having to have a dedicated truck that spends 3 days on the road getting to the venue, that kind of stuff?
Well, first going back to our business model, because I'm glad you mentioned PGA Tour, because it's a perfect use case where an hourly model doesn't fit PGA, because that's a multi-day event where a lot of setup and teardown time and rehearsal time and stuff. So having to run it on an hourly model becomes too expensive, but an annual model, it's crazy for PGA Tour, because it's and similar for things like March Madness or other kind of tournament things where they run for extended time, where hourly is too short and yearly is too long. So having the models to fit between that, we're seeing then that, you know, the technologies are rapidly improving to do live production in the cloud. Now PGA Tour is going to be a really difficult one because there's so many signals in so many places, and I would think of all the sports events you could mention, that might be the last one that goes to the cloud. You know, in a big way, you know, with actual live production, just because of the volume of cameras and signals and things and locations you're covering and such. But we're seeing like Olympics, you know, a big move to the cloud for what they're doing. And that makes a lot of sense because, the way they're doing it, it allows them to really scale up and do things and also pre-build things that they don't have to fly over the world to actually run. So I think, you know, we're seeing that happen. It's also that you can scale on demand. So it's also applies to people doing live news, for example, where we see organizations who want to be able to spin up 100 multi-viewers mosaics for their operators working from home, so producers can work from home and each have total control over what they want to see in a live news event and manage that and things. So we're seeing this, you know, all across the board, that different media companies are finding ways to get to the cloud that really bring benefit. And that benefit is both the way they produce content and create, but also economics, that it allows them to do things they couldn't do before.
Right. Excellent. Well, Peter, thanks so much for time. Really appreciate it as always.
My pleasure. Thanks.
We'll see you soon somewhere online.
I hope so. And one of these days back together again. I can't wait.
Exactly.
It feels like it's getting closer.
Yeah. Well, thanks again. Appreciate all your time.
My pleasure. Thanks. Bye.